In this video, we're going to be looking at how to join the dots on top of J's and I's so that they stay together when you're cutting them. And I'm going to show you two different methods on how to do this, depending on the look you want to achieve. So I've got my word on the screen. I'm going to click on it. And then I'm going to right click and I'm going to select the option Convert to Path. Now bear in mind that as we do this, what's going to happen to this word is it's no longer going to be editable as a word. So you won't be able to change the text. It sort of becomes a shape. So you can see when I move this now, it all comes out of place. You can't really edit it anymore as text. Okay, I'll just undo that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to move these down so that they just overlap slightly on top of the J and the I here, like that. And then all you need to do really is click and drag from the right so that we highlight everything. And then we come over here and we select the weld option from the side menu. Click there, and there you go. Now that's all joined. Okay, so that's the first method. And now I'm going to show you a second method. Okay, so for the second method, what I'm going to do is I'm going to come over here to the rectangle option and I'm going to click on it and I'm going to draw a little rectangle, something like that. And I'll just change the color to black because I really want it to match. So I'm just going to click there to change it to black. And then I'm going to click the select tool and I'm going to drag this over to here. And I might make it a little bit taller. And then I'm going to rotate it slightly. Okay, so I've got that there and I'm going to move it into place. Then I'm going to go Command Copy, and you can do Control C or Control V depending on whether you're on a Mac or a Windows computer. So I've got a second one and I'm going to do the same over here. Okay, and I'm going to do the same thing I did before, click and drag from the side to highlight everything and then click Weld. Okay, now that might look a little bit odd, so some people don't use this option. I don't like it as much, but sometimes you have to depending on the text you've used. You can also just move the dots on top down, and I'll just show you what I mean by that. I'll just undo all this. Right, so what you can do is do what we did with the previous version and click on the text, right click and convert to path. And now we can move these down slightly, so they don't look so odd. And then we bring this back and I might just duplicate this one now. I'm going to right click and duplicate. So I've got two of them. Drag one over. If you've got problems, you'll notice how this sort of wants to click into place and it's very hard to move sometimes. What you can do is come up to settings and you can see how you've got these snapping options. You could always just uncheck them. And then it just makes it a little easier to move these around. There you go, and then the other one, bring that over. Okay, and again, highlight everything from the right there, and then click the weld option. And that looks a little better when they're further down like that. But the option is yours. It just will depend on the text. Sometimes it doesn't look good with that there, sometimes it does. I do prefer the previous option. It just looks a lot better to me. But that's how you do that, so thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this tutorial and it was helpful, please give us a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe for more.